Hello and welcome back to Rimworld. Last time, we continued to build up the defensive line, which is currently, I will note, going quite exceptionally well, because the guns are currently, we got 3 out of the 6 guns, which, I mean, when you actually think about it, that's only half the guns, and that's not actually all that many. But, you know, it's more than zero, and I think we have a pretty good spread at this point, so I don't think anyone's going to take us down pretty easily. But most of the time we were spending on the defensive line, partially on the main machine guns, as well as these new internal defenses, which are arguably exclusively for putting down internal rebellions. But you know what? Magar and Bradley have spun them really well. They've said they're supposed to keep out, I don't know, some form of pest, probably? I mean, I don't exactly know what sort of stuff the people on Rimworld are really concerned about, like whether or not they're concerned that turtles will enter their colony and potentially, I don't know, eat their potato plants. Pretty sure turtles don't eat potato plants. I mean, having never actually, like, touched a potato plant, I think potato plants are pretty, like, rough greens, but again, I've never actually touched the greens of a potato plant, so that is a small problem. And might I note, there's also still a huge, huge horde of beavers down there. Those guys need to get wiped out basically immediately. I'm going to get a couple people on that. They're going to tear them to pieces just as soon as they're done listening to Bradley do a little chat here. Nice job, guys. Good job, everyone. Can we get... Not Cherie. We need people with machine guns, because machine guns are clearly the way that we should take down a bunch of beavers. Because that's not, like, excessive or anything. No, not at all. It's perfectly fine. Don't worry about it. I know you're freaking out over the waste of machine gun ammunition, but I can assure you this game has no ammunition, which makes it significantly easier. You know, it would be kind of horrific if these alpha beavers, just the entire pack, suddenly turned on us and tried to kill us. Because, as has been stated in the past, there is nothing more dangerous in Rimworld than a horde of animals trying to kill you. And I'm pretty sure these beavers are fairly formidable enemies. I mean, last I heard, beaver teeth were pretty serious. Ooh. Hello, bulk goods trader. We called for those guys last time. I do remember that. We're gonna buy some components from them, I believe it was. That should work out quite nicely. Let's get Magar to actually have a chat with them. Where are you, traders? Come on, show yourselves. There we are. Magar, go try to purchase something from them. I'm going to continue to instruct these two to kill every beaver in existence. Ooh. Well, that guy tried to fight back. Unfortunately, it just so happens that a single beaver is not actually a match for two people with machine guns. I mean, this is one of those, like, I really would never have expected that one, but you know, apparently it's the case that machine guns beat beavers. I don't know. That's just how it goes, mate. Let's just melee attack the remainder to death. We're gonna, of course, butcher and eat them, as we do with all standard opponents that we fight. Except for humans, you know. We don't actually eat the humans. Will they buy human flesh? Oh, you guys are disgusting. Why would you buy human flesh from us? I mean, that does beg the question of why we have human flesh to begin with as well, but I would prefer to not answer that question, as I'm pretty sure there are some legal issues implicit in that. But, you know, that's just how it goes. So, in terms of this selling, we've sold off the human meat, we're buying some components, we're selling some more smoke leaf. Is there anything else we want to sell? Definitely not our iguana. Never the iguana. In fact, we're only gonna ever get 73 bucks from it. No. You gotta charge a lot more than 73 bucks to get an iguana out of us. Can we sell a buffalo? They're not really actually that expensive when you think about it. I don't know. I think that's all that we want to sell, despite the fact that, you know, I really want to sell more stuff and get all the monies, but we don't really have the potential to do so. We're getting 8 components off of this, so that's pretty good. Let's just accept that, get those components, and we should be able to use those to build up 2 more of these gun placements. And that, my friends, should be quite beautiful. Long Nose, are you really, like, lavishing in the death of that beaver? Because I feel like if a beaver is incapacitated, it really should take someone only, like, one or two hits. Especially when you have a rifle, really the best move would be to just walk up to it and just shoot it in the head. I mean, you don't actually have to beat the beaver to death. Just saying, I mean, clearly these colonists really enjoy the act of killing animals because every time they're told to kill something, once it's already downed, they try to beat it to death. Which, if I was to choose a way to kill things, it definitely would not be beating it to death. It's just way too much effort. I mean, if you're going to take something down that you've already probably shot 2, 3, maybe 4 times in the gut, I mean, you might as well just take the last bullet to actually, you know, properly kill them off. What the heck is going on here? What the heck? I think they just got into a fight with a bear and ran away? That was weird. I'm pretty sure they just fought a bear. The bear was not happy. Taylor here appears to have been abandoned by his friends, which I'm going to question whether or not they were his friends. And now that they're gone, anyone want to capture Taylor? I'm going to capture Taylor. I have no problem with that. Oh, I see. I see. The bear tried to eat their chicken, and of course they retaliated by killing the bear. Oh, that makes sense. But Taylor got downed, and I guess they have some sort of, like, social Darwinian system where it was survival of the fittest. And they, oh, because you captured Taylor, the Western Herda Non-Technologist Covenant is now your enemies. Ah. Uh-huh. Yeah. Well, that's not good. That is not what, it's not exactly what I wanted out of that situation. Can we have a small chat, guys? You did abandon him on the ground. Evan Rawls hurt some epithets into the microphone and disconnects. What? Oh, come on. No, no, talk to me here. We can increase our will. We can be fine. No? Oh, dang it. Wait, can we chat with the raccoon men? Because I'm pretty sure they hate us too. No, they really want nothing to do with us. Would releasing Taylor help at all? I don't know if that's a thing. I think at this point we have to commit to our current situation, and I'm just going to go with Taylor, you're now going to be a member of our colony, and if you're not going to be a member of our colony, I'm going to do terrible things to you. So you better join us. I mean, just remember, Taylor, what situation led you to being a prisoner of ours, which was mostly your friends completely and totally abandoned you for no apparent reason. Apparently getting killed by a bear is enough to just abandon your friends. I mean, I'm now exceptionally happy that we have such a robust defensive line, because I'm pretty sure those guys are at least slightly decent in terms of firepower, so yeah, we're really gonna need all those guns. And if we could just get that last gun, that'd be beautiful, but I'm pretty sure we don't have any components. I'm just gonna guess that that's a thing, because that was basically where it was at prior. Yeah, that's probably how it is. We really need to, like, prioritize this workbench. I don't know. You can't really prioritize things, can you? It's really annoying. Let's see. What other kind of work do we have? That's suspended. That's suspended. Gun. Not entirely suspended, but nobody's really working on it. We got the smelter. We can suspend smelt metal from slag to kind of speed that up. And it's really this that's then getting in the way, the smoke leaf production. We're going to suspend that. And hopefully that'll cause Cherie to focus on building actual components, which is what we kind of need right now in the colony. We need a million and a million billion and a half components. And quite frankly, we don't have any remaining on the map, unless there's some in here somewhere, which would be nice, I will admit. I will also say, I'm very happy that no giant beetles have formed in our little cave here. Usually, something like this would breed terrible mutant bug creatures, but apparently not Sheree. Did you just take a few pot shots at a turkey and then walk away? Sheree, come on. Come on, Sheree. Work with us here just a little bit. And by the way, it appears that no, in fact, we cannot clear out stone by building floors and then tearing them up. We tried that. That didn't work, so we're not going to have a moat along this area, which is kind of unfortunate. When I say that, I mean really unfortunate, because I would really like a moat there, but you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. And we do have mortars as well. Oh, setting up a few of these. Imagine just having a nice mortar back here. When our opponents come, we just start by shelling them with artillery. Oh, that'd be beautiful. I mean, we do actually need artillery shells at the same time, I think. I mean, I'm pretty sure artillery shells are a thing. I don't know about you, but I'm 90% certain that exists, and I don't really know how to make an artillery shell at this point, which kind of complicates things just a teensy, tiny little bit. Tiny? Never. That's weird. But anyway, yeah, the mortars will happen eventually, I'm sure. What? A pack of man-hunting elephants? And it's actually a pack of elephants. I mean, I'm gonna level with you. I really want to eat those, but okay, fine. We'll do what we should really do in this situation. We are forbidding exit from the colony. Nobody is leaving. We are just going to not deal with man-hunting elephants at all. I mean, in the very least, that should help with priorities, because people are going to be doing more, like, crafting stuff now, because they can't actually get out of the colony, because there's a couple elephants that want to kill everything. And quite frankly, we should really not be walking around when there are elephants trying to kill people. That is kind of a thing. So what else do we have here? Probably at some point we want to extend the hydroponics basin, but right now that's not a big concern. What is Sheree doing? Because Sheree is supposed to be our main crafter. She does have something like 14 crafting. That's ridiculous. That is ridiculous. She does so much crafting. Sheree, if you could just, like, get on the production of, I don't know, components, that'd be great. Sheree! Sheree! Craft the stinking components, Sheree. Why are you butchering things instead of crafting things? Go for it, Sheree. I don't care about the beaver. We don't 100% need the beavers to be butchered immediately. In fact, honestly, we probably don't need the beavers to be butchered at all. Just saying. Ooh, electric cremation. We got that. I mean, I never use electric You know, we could cremate all of the dudes that die. Instead of having these houses of the dead, we could just cremate their bodies. That's a good idea. Like, where's electric cremation in all of this? Do we have a cremator? I'm not seeing it. Is it under production? Electric crematorium. Dude, we could just stick it in here and have a little crematorium. Oh, that'd be beautiful. Do we have enough blocks? We don't have enough blocks of anything to really make that. Can we make it out of something else? No, we have to make it out of some form of stone block. So we'll have to get that first, as well as the actual components to build that. But that could be a good way of getting rid of opponents' bodies after this. So basically, we don't have these massively filled houses of the dead, which I don't know about you, but it's kind of disconcerting that they're just filled with skeletons all the time. And not just skeletons, but just skeletons of random creatures. Just completely random, weird creatures. Aiden, Bradley, I can't help but note that you're literally doing nothing. If you could possibly get on Smokeleaf, that'd be great. Oh, that's tribal wear. We need to unsuspend that. I'm pretty sure that should give Aiden or someone something to do. There we go. Aiden is now doing Smokeleaf joints. Sheree's working on components, as is necessary. Steven's actually building an assault rifle, which is rather nice. I appreciate that. Aw, life is going well, despite the fact that we are currently trapped in our colony by a couple really, really angry elephants that are just basically trampling our sandbags right now. I'm very happy that they aren't breaking our guns. I mean, I'm not certain that an elephant would be very good at destroying a machine gun. I mean, I guess it would really depend on what kind of machine gun. Like, I'm pretty sure an elephant could destroy a Bren gun pretty... a Lewis gun pretty quickly. Just kind of step on it and it would just crumple. But something like, I don't know, a Vickers, which these are definitely closer to Vickers than they are to Lewis guns. That's going to be a bit harder for an elephant to just come up and be like, hey, bro, I like your machine gun. It would be a shame if something were to happen to it and then just crush it. Because they're disgusting heathens. You know what we could do? As I said previously, we do need an open field out in front of the colony. What if we take that to a whole new extreme and we just actually cover the floor in, like, stone so that nothing can grow here? That sounds exceptionally expensive, like ridiculously over-the-top expensive, but also kind of awesome. And you know what we can do? We can do a little, like, floor right along here. And, wood floor. This entire area. So it kind of looks like a drawbridge, and we can pretend that we have a drawbridge, even though we clearly don't have a drawbridge, because that's ridiculous. Why would we ever have that? I don't even actually want a drawbridge. I just think it would be cool to have it look like it, but we can have, like, a walkway into the colony in the very least. It'll be beautiful. I mean, if we actually beautify this place a bit, this could be a really nice looking colony, just saying. I mean, at this point, we're basically working with the most simple of aesthetics, just whatever works, but we could fix this up a lot. Ooh, Mega Sloth Wool. I mean, I'm not certain that we want Mega Sloth Wool all that much, just to be honest. It's not necessarily the most important stuff. By the way, did the sound give out? Yeah, I'm fairly certain the sound died. I don't know why that happens. Occasionally, the sound in RimWorld just decides to stop being a thing. Oh yeah, Ibex, you've gone mad too. You know, Ibex, in comparison to the various elephants that are currently rampaging around, I'm really, really not intimidated by you, just saying. Giant elephants are definitely far more dangerous. And no, in case you're wondering, I'm not gonna revitalize the sound because the video is like, it's gonna be one more minute, something like that. I don't feel it's worth it, you know? It takes completely turning off the game and turning it back on again, which is more than a bit annoying on my part. And I mean, does anyone actually want to listen to a bunch of elephants trumpeting around outside? I don't think so. I don't think anyone wants to listen to an elephant. Elephants are dumb and have nothing to say to us, actually. Honestly, elephants are rather intelligent, so just saying, that's, it's a bit of slander against elephant kind, but there you go. Oh, Fedosha's now getting in on the whole smoke leaf business. Oh my word, these people know where it's at. I mean, I'm not sure how many people are actually going to show up to trade with us anymore now that we've, I think, estranged one of the two groups that actually trades with us. We're basically going to be completely dependent on the orbital trade to do the work, which is, you know, maybe not the best situation, but you gotta do what you gotta do. Oh, everything is just going nicely. Anyway, with the colony currently slightly trapped by at least one crazy elephant. I don't know where the other one went, actually. It appears to have just, I don't know, disappeared. As I was saying, with the colony trapped by a single very angry elephant, that will bring us, for now, to the end of the episode. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this, like and subscribe. Next time, I'm pretty sure the elephant is going to be gone by next time. And we'll be able to leave the colony once again. Hopefully, I don't even know what we do outside of the colony. What? Do we just, like, kill things and eat them? Pretty sure that's the only reason we leave the colony, to kill things and eat them. That's a pretty admirable reason to leave a colony, I would say. Anyway, until then, thanks for watching, and of course, as always, enjoy the rest of your day.